difficulties.
Shall we put our hands together and welcome? Led by Anita Williams, and then we proceed with the other prayers. Going into prayer. So let's just remain in an attitude of prayer and remain focused. Remember, we're focusing not upon ourselves, but upon our Heavenly Father, who's here with us at this time.
Pray for the ladies. Oh God, by your grace of godly friendship of faith. Bless our Bishop Leopold and all other clergy and all our people. Grant that by your word may be truly preached and truly heard, your sacraments faithfully administered and faithfully received. By your Spirit, fashion our lives accordingly to the example of your Son, and grant that you will show the power of love to all among whom we live. Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Amen. Amen.
I just wondered at this time if I can ask Verna to lead us in that that chorus, Holy Spirit, you're welcome in this place. I know she sings it beautifully. Verna, would you mind?
When they rise and when they fall. Watch over our children and young people in every area of their life and keep them safe. Lord, we pray our children and young people to know your goodness and provision. We pray that they would place their identity in you. We ask that in the pressures of life, they would know you are the rock on which they can stand. We pray that through the challenges of school life, exams, and future decisions, you would lead them, guide them, and bring them comfort. Lord God, help our children and young people to find faith in the midst of chaos. Give them the desire and ability to see you, hear you, talk to you, and give thanks to you. We pray that they will draw nearer and nearer to you in their lives. In Jesus' name we pray with thanksgiving.
Amen.
Please all stand as we sing this wonderful hymn, which is quite appropriate for the theme. What a friend we have in Jesus.
Almighty and eternal God, sanctify and open our hearts and bodies,
in the ways of your laws and the ways of your commandments, that under your protection, now and ever, we may be preserved in body and soul through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Prayer for the parishes. Almighty and ever-living God, ruler of all things in heaven and earth, hear our prayers for our parish families. Strengthen the faithful, arouse the careless, restore the penitent. Grant us all things necessary for our common life, and bring us all to be of one heart and mind within your holy church. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Sorry, there's a lot of standing and sitting, but it's good exercise. Let's stand again and sing Sweet Hour of Prayer.
Calls me from
sleeping among us, Brody and Sam. Can you stand there and do it? Brody's going to read a poem for us. Shall we give her a round of applause?
God is in every tomorrow. God is in every tomorrow that I live for today. Certain of finding at sunrise guidance and strength for the day. Power for each moment of weakness. Hope for each moment of pain. Comfort for each sorrow. Sunshine and joy after rain. God is in every tomorrow, planning for you and for me. Even in the dark, I will follow trust where my eyes cannot see. Still by his promise of blessings, soothed by the touch of his hand, confident in his protection, knowing my life path is planned.
Let's just applaud her again for that. Kieran is going to follow that action. with me that the Gracia dance, the Gracia, is my English accent, the Gracia, dance performing company were excellent. Young people using their talents and their gift for the purpose, for the Lord, giving thanks to the Lord, they worshiping the Lord. Let's give them another round of applause. To go on to the next appointment, we're going to say thanks to them and Gary is going to the office. And we want to just to bless you as the Lord blesses you. Yeah.
On behalf of us, to you and the dancers, for that very inspiring and energetic performance that we saw this morning. And we'd like to wish you Godspeed, continued progress and success in your endeavors.
Wow.
Endorsing what Deacon O'Gara just said, and to add that you have always been there for Pick and Call, and for that we want to present
I support
you.
My American church.
Wow, very impressive. And on behalf of Team De Gracia, I want to express my gratitude to Reverend Daniel and her team from that's not a British accent. And her team from St. Matthew's Biabou. Thank you. Muchas gracias, merci. We appreciate this. Muchas gracias.
Thank you very much.
Those who are watching would agree with us that they've missed out, and that's why. Kissinger is now going to read the scripture reading for us. So all stand, please.
Matthew 6th chapter, reading from verses 5 to 14. And when thou prayest, thou shalt not be as the hypocrites are, for they love to pray standing in the synagogues and in the corners of the street, that they may be seen of men. Verily I say unto you, they have their reward. But thou, when thou prayest, enter into thy closet, and when thou shalt shut the door, pray to the Father which is in secret, and thy Father which is in secret shall reward thee openly. But when you pray, use not vain repetition, as the heathens do, for they think that they shall be heard of their much speaking. But be not ye therefore like unto them, for your Father knoweth what things ye have need of before ye ask it. After this manner, therefore, pray, our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive those our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. For if you forgive men their trespasses, your heavenly Father will also forgive you. There ends the reading.
Thanks be to God.
Brothers and sisters, a pleasant morning. I have never been more pleased to perform this task. Miss Inga Jackson is a member of the St. Philip's Anglican Parish, Mesopotamia, and currently serves as the president of the Anglican Church Women's Association Archdeaconry Committee in the Archdeaconry of St. Vincent and the Grenadines. Inga is very much involved in the life of her parish. She has served as priest warden, junior choir coordinator, priest warden, choir member, and as chair or committee member on various committees developed for specific purposes. As a professional, she is the plant engineer with responsibility for Cane Hall, Diesel Power Station, and the South Rivers, Richmond, and the Cumberland Hydro Power Stations at Binley. She is also a member of Toastmasters International and has held various executive positions in her home club. Growing up with an Anglican grandmother, Inga learned to recite her prayers at an early age. It was prayers as she woke up on mornings and prayers before going to bed. And as the years rolled by, she has learned other means of prayer. She admits that she has often fallen short in prayer and sometimes loses focus on the coming great day. But if there is a lesson to be learned from her involvement in various roles, it's that she can't, and we can't, make it without prayer. Brothers and sisters, it is my distinct pleasure to introduce to you our guest speaker for today, Sister Inga Jackson.
Perhaps we could sing a first verse, if we know it. I only know the chorus.
These are the days of Elijah.
Thy kingdom come on earth. as Jesus has taught us. We heard that in the reading this morning. But you know, it's easy to sing that chorus. And it's easy to say, pray on. But sometimes it's really hard to pray on. And sometimes we feel like we don't have the time to dedicate to that prayer. And when we do pray, it seems like it's not enough. And sometimes we go to prayer, but we don't know what to pray. Because prayer indeed requires grace from God. So let us look at prayer. Perhaps a few things might help us a little bit along our way as we prepare. Perhaps a question, what is prayer? So, I take this opportunity to pick on somebody who's going to tell me, to you, what is prayer? And I'm talking about my sister right here. Look, I don't know anybody sitting next to Sister Margaret in a pretty red and green and blue dress. Sister, so what is prayer to you? Yes, you.
Well, I think prayer for me, that prayer to God, because He are the one who does help us.
So,
He always with us.
All right. Calling out to God, the one who helps us.
Yes, sir.
Anybody else want to share? What is prayer to you?
Having a conversation with God.
Having a conversation with God. And anyone, one more who would like to share?
Connection between you and God.
Now, there are some definitions for prayer, but I would like to use the one that's in our catechism. For those of us who have our prayer book, there's a definition for prayer on page 405. What is prayer? Prayer is responding to God by thought, by feeling, and by deeds, with or without words. In essence, this just summarizes what we've been saying here. That is prayer. And the next question, why do we pray? Why do we pray?
To build our relationship with God.
To build our relationship with God. Why do we pray?
So that God's will can be done on earth as it is done in heaven.
So that God's will can be done on earth as it is in heaven. Why do we pray?
So that help come from God, so we pray to Him.
Pray for help.
Pray for our own needs and those of others.
And we pray for our own needs. Does anybody pray because Jesus said we should pray? Well, maybe that's a good reason too why we should pray. Because He did tell us we should pray. And indeed, I believe that prayer, that's our way of strengthening our relationship with God. If we're going to prepare to meet Him. Sometimes we refer to Him as the bridegroom. We as the bride. We've got to know Him. We got to communicate with Him, build a relationship with Him. And so we pray. And you know what prayer does? It gives us such a beautiful opportunity for God to walk through us. Because God is good. All the time, God is good. And God continues to do great and marvelous things within our midst. But how great is our God that He allows us that opportunity to pray. To pray for our brothers and our sisters and see God working and healing and doing what we ask. God could have done it on His own, but He gave us that opportunity. Isn't prayer beautiful? It's a beautiful thing to pray. And then I ask, when do we pray? Every time. Prayer without ceasing. That's kind of hard. Prayer without ceasing. But sometimes we know we dedicate a special time to pray. When I was growing up, I was told, when you get up first thing in the morning, pray. And before you go to bed and lie down, prayed. And at that time, you couldn't say you're going on the bed and lie down and pray. You go kneel down by the side of the bed and pray. Now, when I was younger, it was just the Our Father prayer. It was the grace. And things turned out quite nicely. But as I got older and started to pray, and I think I want to do a little bit more prayer, when first thing I got up in the morning and I pray, at least I tried to pray, I would find, you know what, it's really working out. I'm somewhere back in La La Land when I get up first thing in the morning and say I'm going to pray. And sometimes you try in the evening, you're so tired. By the time you say, Oh Father, you find yourself on your knee for 3 hours. Sleep, fast asleep, your knee hurting you. Why? Fall asleep, pray. So when do we pray? For me personally, when do you set aside that time to pray? Anytime. Well, some people could make it anytime. Some of us need a specific time where we dedicate that time for prayer. And for me, it's still in the morning, but it's not the first thing. So I would get up, I would make the bed, brush my teeth, get a little loud, and get out of the bedroom and go to the desk, because if I stay in that bedroom, back to sleep. And for some of us, it may be that. I remember one of the impactful things that Bishop had taught us, Bishop Friday, was that you don't have to pray before you go to bed or save that time because when you're tired. Choose a time when you're alert. Set aside that time and pray. Your dedicated time. So now we are talking about time. How long should we pray for? That's a tricky one. Well, if we were to follow some of the, like for example, when we Jesus in Gethsemane, and he came to Peter, not even an hour you could stay with me. It suggests that you should pray for at least an hour. And we just sang the hymn, sweet hour of prayer, sweet hour of prayer. That? How many of us could spend that hour? Some of us do, not all the time, sometimes. But I think the most important thing for us is to set aside a time. If you're going to start with 15 minutes. Let's start with 15 minutes. But that time is dedicated. It should not be just a time within our calendar or the daily activities. Oh yeah, I have to pray. And then everything happens in the day except the prayer. It should be a time that is set aside for prayer. Consciously, that this is my prayer time. Some of us are a little bit more sophisticated. We have prayer closets. We have prayer chairs. We have prayer room. Some of us have opportunities get to go to the chapel and pray. But some of us, we don't have that. But within our own time, we set aside the time for prayer. And you know, sometimes we really don't know what to say a lot of times. I mean, we would say we're going to pray and then we would just pray. Whatever, as we say, the spirit places on our heart to pray about, we would pray. We would pray for our brothers and our sisters, the needs that we know. And sometimes, if you're like me, after you finish praying, you remember, oh boy, I forget to pray for somebody. But there are ways and means to help us in our prayer and in our prayer lives, to assist us. And someone to share with you some of these things, because some of them we know, but some of them we forget. Let's start with our first aid, the Book of Common Prayer. In the Book of Common Prayer, we have there a format for morning prayer and a format for evening prayer. And that format allows us to do psalms, to do scriptures, to sing, and to have time for other prayers, whether intercessory and so on. That allows us to do that. It would take us about more than 15 minutes for sure, to go through the morning prayer. Maybe 30 to 45 minutes, depending on how much you want to sing. and how much readings you want to do. But that's an access for us. There are times when we're on holiday, we're not rushing out. Why not use the morning prayer and evening prayer? And even though we want to use the format of the evening prayer, the morning prayer, within the same book, we have countless prayers. We have countless litanies. Litany of thanksgiving. Litany of penitence that we could use. We have the collects that we could pray. They are not just limited for Sunday, but there are some collects that would resonate with you within a specific period of time, within a specific difficulty, and you pray using your collect. So why not use the book of common prayer? And you know, for those of us who are a little bit more into technology, we have at our midst the lectionary page. And on that lectionary page, there's actually a link for morning and evening prayer. As a matter of fact, morning, evening, compline, any prayer you want, it's there. But I particularly love the morning prayer, which is on the site for Mission Sinclair, because you don't have to worry about choosing the hymn. They give you a hymn. You don't have to worry about what reading. Let me look in the back of this thing. Oh, I don't have the New Revised Lectionary. The readings are there. The psalm is there. And the beauty about this particular site is that when there's a saint day, they would give a commemoration of that saint. And that has been one of my favorites, because when you read about the saints and various aspects of their lives, there's some inspiration. As a matter of fact, sometimes they tell us about the prayers of these saints. So sometimes, you know, I just steal some of them, like I made their prayer my prayer at the end of the day. I would share with you, for example, a prayer that I stole, basically. And this is from the Lancelot Andrews, who was the Bishop of Winchester. And one of his prayers says, "Coming to God, I believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. I know that my Redeemer liveth, that he is the Christ, the Son of the living God, that he is indeed the Savior of the world, and that he came into the world to save sinners, of whom I am the chief. Through the grace of Jesus, we believe that we will be saved, even as our forefathers did. I believe verily to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living." How could you pass up such treasures? They are there, accessible to us. Different forms of prayer. So we have our morning and evening prayer, our common book of prayer, and access to this online that we can use. But there are other forms of prayer. Novenas. Christmas. Advent novena will soon be here. 9 days before Christmas. You call it 9 mornings. How many of us use the format of novena to pray? You know, recently the bishop encouraged all of us to join him in a novena for the elections. Some of us did. Some of us didn't. But novena is accessible to us because it's a prayer, a specific prayer for a special intention. It doesn't have to be Christmas. It doesn't have to be election. It could be something that you desire or a decision that you have to make. And you set aside 9 days to pray for that intention. And so we could do novenas all year round. It's something that's accessible to us for prayer. And I learned recently that novena could actually be 9 hours instead of 9 days. So 9 hours consecutively, which I thought was interesting. But there you have it. Another format to pray. Keep our prayer life moving. And how about praying the Psalms? Praying the Psalms. You choose a psalm. So for those of us who have our prayer book, we could probably choose the psalm, one of the psalms for today, 144. Psalm 144. And you read through the psalm. So that's the first step in praying the psalm. There are different formats, but this is just one that I'm sharing. We read through the psalm. "Blessed be the Lord my rock, who trains my hand to fight and my fingers to battle. My help and my fortress, my stronghold and my deliverer, my shield in whom I trust, who subdues the peoples under me. Oh Lord, what are we that you should care for us? Mere mortals that you should think of us. We are like a puff of wind. Our days are like a passing shadow. Bow your heavens, O Lord, and come down. Touch the mountains, and they shall smoke. Hurl the lightnings and scatter them. Shoot out your arrows and rub them. Stretch out your hand from on high. Rescue me and deliver me from the great waters, from the hand of foreign peoples, whose mouths speak deceitfully, and whose right hand is raised in falsehood. God, I will sing to you a new song. I will play to you on a 10-stringed lyre. You give victory to kings, and you have rescued David from your servants. Rescue me from the hurtful sword. Deliver me from the hand of foreign peoples, whose mouths speak deceitfully, and whose right hand is raised in falsehood. May our sons be like plants well nurtured from their youth, and our daughters like sculpted corners of the palace. May our barns be overflowing with all manner of crops. May the flocks in our pastures increase by thousands and tens of thousands. May our cattle be fat and sleek. May there be no breaching of walls, no going into exile, no wailing in public squares. Happy are the people of whom this is so. Happy are the people whose God is the Lord. Now when you've read that psalm, now the second part is to go step by step. Take a verse and pray. Because you see, if we were to read, blessed be the Lord my rock, who trains my hand to fight and fingers to battle, what would you pray for when you read that? You would probably give God praise.
Amen.
You would say, thank you, Jesus, for delivering me, who have strengthened me through my trying times. And then you may read another verse that say, may our sons be like plants well nurtured from their youth, and our daughters like, and then we pray for our children, and we go through our psalm verse by verse. It encourages us to pray things that we would not even think about praying for within at that particular time, but the psalm allows us to do that. And you know the beauty about the psalm, they allow us and they open our eyes to see that we could come before God and we could pray without feeling embarrassed because we are complaining or because we think something is not going right. It basically opens up a way for us to see, you know, we could come to God with anything. And of course, you have some strong language, then you could really pick up some nice words for praying when you read your psalms. That's the beauty of praying the psalms, another avenue for us to use when we pray. And then we have praying the hymns. Well, for those of us, we know there is no comparative within our Anglican hymns, as we would say. There's nothing like them. The words could be prayers for us. And we too could pray our hymns. I will tell you one of the hymns that spoke to me last Sunday, because, you know, it was one of the communion hymns. And now, Father, mindful of the Lord, that brought us once for all on Calvary Street. And having with us him that pleads above, we here present, we here set forth to thee, the only offering perfect in thine eyes, the one true pure immortal sacrifice. And we read that and we pray. We recognize that we cannot come before God without Jesus. And that sets us on a different level. We give God thanks for who he is. Because, you know, we pray, Lord, you know, don't look at us. Look upon his face. Look upon Jesus and have mercy on us. And there's a verse that says, and then for those, our dearest and our best, by this prevailing presence we appeal. Oh, fold them closer to thy mercy's breast. Oh, do thine utmost for their souls to weal. From taint and mischief, keep them white and clean, and crown thy gifts with strength to cultivate. And we pray that for us. We pray for our family. We pray for our children. Because I'm certain the gifts that they're talking about is a gift for our children. And we pray for God's mercy on those whom we love. We pray for him. And there, another avenue for us to pray. And you know, we could sing. We don't just have to read, but we could sing. There is a quote that says, to sing is to pray twice. In my case, I think singing sometimes could be thrice and four times. Because sometimes you sing and that song resonates with you. And while you're singing within your heart, you pray. There's just like the spirit is, your mouth is singing the words, but your spirit is lifting up a cry unto God. Amen. Praying twice when you sing. Prayer hymns. These are accessible to us. And we could pray. We have prayer calendars from time to time. We designate a month for specific prayer. We say, okay, sometimes in this case, in Advent, there are Advent calendars, there are Christmas calendars, there are Lenten calendars. But you can make your own calendar by the time of the year because you have specific things that you want to pray for. Why not use the prayer calendars?
Yes.
And for, it's not so much a tradition, I think, for Anglicans, but there are places like the Catholics who pray the rosary. You know, that's another form of prayer that we have accessible to us and could use. And praying without ceasing. I think one of the easiest way for us to pray without ceasing is to use what is called the arrow prayer. What's the arrow prayer? As it is short and sweet. Yes, Sister Joy?
And the same is one that is at the fast when the need comes.
Yes. So that's what it is. It's a short one sentence, no long story. A short sentence, whatever it is. It could be Thanksgiving. It could be a plea for help. It could be intercession. You know, sometimes you're going down the road and somebody tells you, all they could say is, Lord, have mercy. Arrow prayer. You know you're going into something and it kind of hard. You could get a little temptation. You know, you take the old father prayer and you say, lead me not into temptation, but deliver me from evil. Arrow prayer. Something happened, and most of us sometimes we don't even pay attention. When you leave in your house in the morning and you reach to work, you say, thank you, Lord, for bringing me to work safely. Arrow prayer. You're home. Thank you, Lord, I reached back home safely. Arrow prayer. And so, why not use these in our prayer time, to develop our prayer life, to pray without ceasing, to continue to be in communion with God. Pray at different seasons. So what I'm trying to say is that there are various means for us to pray. Sometimes we get stuck in a rut, and then we find it difficult. But we have so many different ways of praying that we could use and spice up our prayer life. Keep us active. Keep us preparing. Use our morning prayer. Do the novenas. Pray the psalm. For example, you could decide, hey, I'm going to pray the psalm for 2 weeks. So your prayer for 2 weeks is going to be praying the psalm. You may choose to do a novena at a different period. And then you go back to morning and evening prayer. So that at the end of it, we are praying, we are communicating, and we are getting closer, building our relationship with God. Because that's what we're here for. We're here so that we can prepare for that great coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. You know, as we would say, the Lord is coming soon. Anybody can finish that?
Amen.
Amen. Come, Lord Jesus. The Lord is coming soon. Amen. Come, Lord Jesus. The Lord is coming soon. Amen. Come, Lord Jesus. Let us, through prayer, develop that relationship and prepare for the coming of our Lord. My brothers and sisters, something big is going to happen. Are you ready?
Wonderful and inspiring and informative and practical presentation about the different aspects and forms of prayer. And I like what he said about using the psalms and the hymns. I tend to use the psalm all the time through prayer as an avenue for prayer. But obviously every individual is different. But there's such a variety of ways of communicating with our Heavenly Father that is available to us, that is there at our fingertips. And I pray that we will be truly inspired in actually rising up to a different level, a higher level in our prayer life, as Christians, as the body of Christ. And don't forget to pray for others as well. Not for ourselves alone, but pray for the needs of others. Pray for the world. I remember my mother used to pray when she thought we were all asleep. And one of the things I noticed is that she used to get up when she thought we were all snoring. And her lips would be moving and she would be interceding and praying for her children, praying for her neighbors, praying for the world, praying for things in the community. That woman was a woman of prayer. And the Lord reminded me just recently, and I was being complacent in my prayer life. There was a time when I was interceding and I was praying, I was really communicating with my Heavenly Father. And when I came to St. Vincent, I was looking around for prayer groups to join. I was getting very frustrated because I couldn't find other like-minded people. I wanted to actually maintain that prayer life, that level of prayer, and take it to a higher level, actually. And the Lord reminded me that, you know, I could pray to Him in my closet. It's good to be in fellowship with others. It's good to be praying with others. But you don't stop praying because you don't have anyone around you to pray. Pray without ceasing. And I learned from my mother that you can pray. Sometimes, you know, you used to see her lips moving. And like Hannah in the Bible, people probably thought she was a bit mad because she used to pray on the bus, she used to pray on the streets, she used to pray everywhere. And so we too should adopt that lifestyle as Christians, to pray without ceasing, pray to our Heavenly Father, and pray from the depths of our hearts. I was reading just recently about the, when we celebrated the Saints' Day, about those saints who sacrificed their lives. And one of the things that struck me about them is that they were people of prayer. People of prayer. They sacrificed their life, but they prayed and they had great faith in God. And although they suffered immensely, sometimes beyond our recognition, they were people of prayer. And they died, many of them died sacrificially. There's a song that's coming to my mind, Faith of Our Fathers. I don't know if we've got a hymn. Can we sing? Mr. Daisley knows me. Sometimes I just come out spontaneously with these hymns or songs, you know, the Holy Spirit can do it by me. Faith of Fathers.
Faith of Fathers.
I hope that we'll go away from this space and think about what is more suitable for us, whether it's the hymns or the psalms or the prayer, Book of Common Prayer. There's such a wide variety, as I said. And now I'm going to just ask us to do a reflection in terms of an activity. We've heard all that we've heard, we've sang, we've eaten, but now we need to come back and remain in that attitude of prayer and worship to our Heavenly Father. So what I'd like us to do is to ask three people to pray out aloud. And I know some people have been thinking, no, I can't do that. But the Holy Spirit is here with us and He's guiding us. And we're in a safe place. And if you're inspired by the Holy Spirit to pray aloud, just three people, we pray for ourselves, we pray for our nation. We're in a time of great uncertainty, a time where there's a lot of fear around us, like an ocean, because we do not know what tomorrow may bring. We have no control about what is happening. We here in St. Vincent have been so immensely privileged, so blessed, so protected. Because when we hear about all that is happening in our neighboring countries and other countries beyond, we have been kept safe. God's hand, I believe, is on this country. And for that we need to praise Him and thank Him, not just for today but at all times, for all that He's done. All that He has done and all that He's about to do. So prayer, I believe, is a key that unlocks the door to Heavenly Father, to usher in His presence among us. So three people would like to do that. And after that, I want to challenge you by asking you to pray for the person next to you. Pray for them as the Holy Spirit needs. I don't want to tell you what to pray for. But we have been given that privilege and that opportunity to pray. And so let's use the time to practice doing that. So let's have some music in the background, Mr. Daisley, please. To aid us as we allow the Holy Spirit to lead and guide us at this time. Please do so at this time.
Father, in the name of Jesus, we come and in the power of the Holy Spirit. We thank you that we can approach your throne at any time, anywhere. We thank you, O God, your word declares we must come boldly to the throne of grace that we may obtain mercy. And Lord, we present ourselves to you, God, as a living sacrifice this morning. Father, I pray for each of us, you know where we are with you. You know, O God, our needs before we ask. Lord, our commitment to you this morning is that we will go in a spirit of prayer.
Yes.
We desire to pray, God.
Yes.
We desire to seek your face. But Lord, sometimes it's a challenge, it's a trial, it's a testing time when we decided to get up and to pray. As our sister reminded us this morning, sometimes we are busy, sometimes we are tired, sometimes we are frustrated, and there are things that prevent us from coming to the throne of grace. But this morning, oh God, we want to commit ourselves afresh. And we pray, oh God, that you would give us a desire,
yes,
that would bring us out of the bed, bring us away from the jobs, bring us away, oh God, to that quiet place. I want to thank you this morning, oh God, that you have raised up this prayer breakfast. You have placed on Reverend's heart the desire to have this in place. And we thank you for her obedience. And we pray, oh God, that as we leave this place, that we will be better for it. Lord, we want to commit our nation before you. Lord, we are known as land of the blessed. Father, you said in Chronicles, if the people that are called by your name, if we humble ourselves and we pray, and we seek your face, oh God, that you would hear from heaven and you would heal our land.
Lord,
we want to thank you for protecting our borders from COVID and all the other things and the ills, oh God. We thank
Amen.
You. We bless your name, oh God. When we see lives are lost in other territories, Lord, we want
yes.
to want to
Amen.
Praise you this morning.
Yes.
And God, we want to worship you because of who you are. Father, I pray for our nation. I pray for our leaders. I pray, oh God, for those in authority. I pray that you would keep them and they would serve with integrity. And, oh God,
Amen.
That your nation would remain a peaceful nation. We pray, oh God, for those persons, dear Father, who keep our security, our police officers, and all the nurses and the teachers and everybody who's part of this land. Lord, we pray for the economic well-being of our nation. We pray for those who are struggling financially. We
Amen.
Ask, oh God, you will provide the needs. And Father, you will meet them where they are. Father, we pray for those who are sick and suffering, those that are lonely, those that are downtrodden this morning. And
Amen.
We ask, oh God, you will meet them in the hour of their needs.
Mm-hmm.
And Father, so we give you thanks. We ask that you would make us a prayerful people. Like Elisha, oh God, he was persistent in prayer. Like Jeremiah and all the prophet of old, as we lay our hearts to you, God, in Jesus' mighty name I pray.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
and they empower us, Lord God, as a church. Help us not to think of any of our sins. But, oh God, whatever the resources you have given us, I pray that we may use. Lord, I pray for the errors, especially in our nation, that needs prayers, oh Father, that you may raise up men and women for this purpose, oh Father.
Yes.
Small groups, so that we can have an effect on our nation. I pray, oh Lord, for our leaders, that, oh God, we will continue to lead us into the right direction. Oh Father, I pray that we also cannot be misled from this. The God speak to us and carry out your mind. These things I do ask in Jesus' name.
Amen. Die on the cross for my redemption. And dear God,
salvation, Lord God. Bless us to see that light which you have sent to us, dear God, in the form of your Son. Please and everything as I ask in your holy precious name.
Amen.
To invite us to now stand and sing, Take My Life and Let It Be, and let this be a prayer for all of us. If you read the words of this hymn, it's actually a prayer. So let's sing it, because it's very meaningful and applicable to us all. Take my life and let it be.
thank you for the splendor of your own creation, for the beauty of the world, for the wonder of life, and for the mystery of life. We thank you for the blessing of family and friends, and for the loving care you surround us on every side. We thank you for setting us stars, which demand our best of you, and for leading us to accomplishment, which satisfy and delight us. We thank you for also for those disappointments and failures that lead us to acknowledge our failures on your earth. Above all, we thank you for your Son Jesus Christ, for the truth of his work and for the example of his life, for his steadfast obedience by which he overcome temptation, for his dying through which he overcome death, for his rising of life in which we are raising to the life of your kingdom. Grant us the gift of your Spirit, that we may know Christ and live in him and truly at all times and in all things may give thanks to you in all things.
Come into our hearts, Lord Jesus. We gather in a season of expectation and wonder. We gather in a season of impossible busyness. Let us pause for a moment and remember why we are here. Thessalonians 5:16-24. Rejoice always, praying without ceasing. In all circumstances give thanks, for this is the will of God for you in Christ Jesus. Do not quench the spirit. Do not despise prophetic utterances. Test everything, retain what is good. Refrain from every kind of evil. If may the God of peace make you perfectly holy, and may your entire spirit and body be preserved blameless for the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ. The one who calls you is faithful, and he will also accomplish it. Your response, come into our hearts, Lord Jesus. God of all goodness and light, we welcome this chance to be still and gather in your presence. Help us to lift our prayers to you as we seek to do your will. Hear us as we pray.
Come into our hearts, Lord Jesus.
The world tells us this is time of plenty and extravagance. Give us eyes to see those who do not have the basic needful things of life. Hear us as we
come into our hearts, Lord Jesus.
The scripture tells us this is time for waiting with joyful hope. Give us ears to hear this message and to glory in its promise. Hear us as we pray.
Come into our hearts, Lord Jesus.
The Virgin tells us that you are God and of surprises and incredible miracles. Give us minds open to be in your power in all things. Hear us as we
pray. Come into our hearts, Lord Jesus.
John the Baptist tells us that it is time to make straight the pathways of the Lord, to do what is right and just for everyone. Give us the courage to act with justice and compassion and mercy in everything we do. Hear us, Spirit.
Come into our hearts, Lord Jesus.
Those seasons tell us the great good news, of our salvation, and the incredible gifts of God coming. One of us in the humblest of circumstances, give us heart wide enough to embrace this wonderful wish and to spread the love of conviction to the humblest among us. Hear us as we pray.
Come into our hearts, Lord Jesus.
The Spirit tells us not to fear, to test everything, to trust in God's goodness and God's faith in us. Give us the Spirit to embrace this promise and let it guide us in our service to others. Hear us as we pray.
Come into our hearts, Lord Jesus.
God in all goodness and light, we praise you for your goodness and unending love. Make us holy and blameless witness if your good news is better.
Amen.
Now it is time for us to give thanks. Firstly, we'd like to thank God for today. I believe we all agree that it is a beautiful day. Bright sunshiny, no rain. We are all able to come. We thank God for inspiring Reverend Daniel to host this prayer breakfast event. We also thank Reverend Daniel for responding to God's call, because sometimes God calls us and we run. She didn't run, but I think she alluded to the fact that she took a while before she responded. But we thank God that she did respond. We thank His Lordship the Bishop for allowing us to use Pastor and Senator this morning. I understand that we don't have to pay anything. Thank the Lord for putting it on the Bishop's heart to help us.
Help the nations.
I'd like to thank Mrs. Janice Glasgow, who's going to duck when I call her name. But you know she's always working behind the scenes to make sure everything.
Yes.
I forgot to thank the Bishop again for the blessing that we received just now. I'd like to thank the caterers. I heard somebody saying the food was good, but I didn't have to say it because they said I was biased. Somebody said the food was good. I'd like to also thank those persons who read scripture readings, who prayed, and who rendered items. We thank the La Gracia dancers already, they've left. And I'd like to thank Acuron, and I believe his sister, Rolene, for the pan rendition and the poem. And I think that's very talented family. I'd like to thank our musician, Mr. John Dillon, for accompanying us throughout this morning. I'd like to thank our guest speaker, Miss Inga Jackson, inspiring, down-to-earth, and practical address to us this morning. We have used some other advocates. And I thank her also for reminding us that we have so many avenues available to us to assist us in prayer, including the prayer book that many of us only use once a week. I thank her for reminding us that we need to put it somewhere where we can use it every day, and even twice or three times a day, rather than only one day a week. So I thank her. I'd like to thank Mr. Monty Cupid. The opportunity to broadcast live to those persons who could not make it here today.
He came at the last minute.
We thank Rev. Said came at the last minute, so we thank him for answering God's call. Nothing is ever too late with God. He's always on time. And finally,
just in case I forgot anybody,
yeah.
I'd like to thank everyone who attended here this morning, both those who came physically and those who are joining us. Compliments of Monty, because we could have all found something else to do, but we thought it fitting to be here. So I thank you all. And also, in a spirit of thanksgiving, I've been asked to remind us that there's a little basket outside. Oh, it's now on the inside. So we have no excuse to say Mrs. Glasgow is holding it up, so we can't possibly miss it. So as we are thankful for what God has done today, we ask that you leave a little donation. Give thanks to God. And so I pray that all that we have experienced here today would help us not only to prepare individually, but to also encourage others to prepare for God's coming. So I thank you, and I thank you.
Your words, your message will surely inspire us
to prepare for the coming of the Lord through prayer. So I invite us all to be very deliberate in what we do in preparation for the coming of our Lord. It is very challenging. There are a lot of pressure, other things being presented to us, influences. The church has set aside this time of Advent to prepare. We know all around us, we are here at this Christmas. But let us seek to, in spite of how important the things that are being introduced are, and we try to ensure that we maintain control and have that moment of preparation, of reflection, of waiting for the coming of Christ and for Christmas. Let us pray. Today at this prayer breakfast, the theme, preparing the way of the Lord through prayer, we pray for our diocese, we would like us to pray for the nations that make up our diocese, for Susan, our Governor General, for Ralph, our Prime Minister, Forgotten opposition leader, parliamentarians and people, to Cecile, Governor General, Keith, Prime Minister, Tobias, opposition leader, parliamentarians and people, Grenada, for Neville, Governor General, Ireland, Prime Minister, Philip, opposition leader, parliamentarians and people, St. Lucia. We have prayed for our children and young people. We have prayed for our protection. We have prayed for our parishes. As we conclude this prayer breakfast, let's remember the words of Holy Scripture, the words of John the Baptist, preparing the way of the Lord through prayer. Repent, for the kingdom of heaven has come near. This is the voice of one whom the prophet Isaiah spoke when he said, the voice of one crying out in the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord, make his path straight. And so may God himself, the God of peace, make you perfect and holy, and keep you safe and blameless, spirit, soul, and body, for the coming of Christ. The blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you now and evermore.
Amen.